They're called the Leonids, the fastest meteors, moving 50 miles per second, burning about 70 miles high in the atmosphere. We happened to catch a glimpse during our broadcast last November, and they're slated to light up the night sky again this month.
Let's talk about where they come from. The constellation Leo, if you could give us a little bit of background information on that and why that's important.
If you trace back a Leonid's path in the sky, they will all appear to have their trails intersect in the constellation of Leo the Lion.
That point where they intersect is called a radiant, and that's how they get their name. The Leonids are leftover debris from comet Temple-Tuttle. The fireball takes about 33 years to go around the sun, leaving behind a trail producing the phenomenon we see every year. Bill Cook has been forecasting meteor showers for NASA since 1998.
ISS, the space station, is heavily armored. It's armored against orbital debris and meteoroids. An astronaut in a spacesuit doesn't have any armor. So we mainly focus on seeing if it's a good time for the astronaut to go outside the ISS and do their work.
Since there's no atmosphere in space, meteors pose more of a threat there. But that's not the case here on land. You can see the spectacular display throughout the end of the month with peak viewing times between midnight and dawn on the 17th, with an average of about 10 streaks per hour. All you gotta do is pick a spot away from city lights, lay flat on your back, and enjoy. And with a waxing crescent moon, the sky will be dark enough for optimal viewing. I'm meteorologist Stacy-Ann Gooden, PIX 11 News.